Welcome to the People Connect podcast. Your network is your net worth. Are you ready to take your life to the next level? Be prepared to leap out of your comfort zone and connect with the who's who of what you want to do. Stop, drop, and roll as we start, market, and grow the CEO of you and your host, Nichelle Womack. She will help you engage, reinvent, motivate, and reactivate your plans for success.
Hey, how you doing, everybody? Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Thank you so much for taking time out of your day. Hey, Testy Donut, Happy New Year to you. How are you? I haven't seen you in quite some time. I pray things are going well with you and for you. Thank you for coming in to join me. Greatly appreciate you. To all my replay viewers, thank you so much for being a special part of my day. Greatly appreciate that. To all those that are seeking new opportunities here in the 2017 year, this message is for you. So greatly appreciate you sharing and connecting. Hey, DRC, I think that's what that says. I'm trying to find my let me put this down for a second. Trying to find my microphone here, just in case, because sometimes I notice my phone goes out here. So if you are seeking a new opportunity in 2017, this message is for you. You are not here by accident. So I am hoping and praying that this message will help elevate you in your life. If you are seeking a job, if you're seeking to start a business, the tips that I'm going to share with you will help fulfill that opportunity. So if you are looking for something new, typically around this time of the year, I know I personally get busy with helping people in the corporate sector, whether it's helping them with their resume or if it's helping employers, small business. I actually do interviewing for small business healthcare companies, helping them to hire staff as well as nursing and other staff members, physicians. If they need some physicians to come in, I help them do all of that. But there are some ways that you can get out there and you can make a connection with people that will enable you to progress in your career. And you know, when I was looking up the job raise, as far as people staying on a job, you know, the longest most right now that people are staying on a job is anywhere from 3 to 5 years. And so what that tells me is a lot of things. First of all, you know, the first of the year, a lot of times what you find, a lot of companies end up closing. Right now we're seeing Macy's, one of the major retailers, Abercrombie and Finch. I think they're closing some stores. The Limited has closed all their stores and they're doing everything online. So what you're seeing now is transition taking place. And as I say all the time in my messages, if you are not prepared for what is about to happen, then you're going to be left behind. And I speak on business all the time. In fact, that is my creative effort there, business. But I also know people perhaps sometimes need income, constant income. And depending on what you do, because businesses can provide that too, jobs give you that constant income until you can build your dream and develop it and pursue it from there. So I work with people of different magnitudes. Majority of the people that I work with are entrepreneurs. But occasionally I do get clients that are saying, you know, look, business is not for me. I'd rather be an intrapreneur versus an entrepreneur. And that's okay, because entrepreneurship is not for the faint at heart. It's not for everyone. So, you know, don't let, if that's your desire, you can elevate in your career and working for someone else. Just keep in mind, you will never own that job. And that's the reality of it. You will never own that job. However, you can move through your career and make a decent amount of money. You know, six figures is nothing to sneeze at. I know that's what I did in pharmaceutical sales when I was in district management and a lot of other positions that I've held. Six figure salaries are not out of reach. Most of those positions require you to have some formal education. However, I still know several people that do quite well at the 50,000 mark, you know, and depending on where you live in the country, because if you're like in New York, that's probably like chump change. But depending on where you live, more so Midwest sector, that's a pretty good living, you know. So finding what works for you, and that's what you have to recognize in 2017. What works for you? My name is Nichelle, and I'm with 2XL with Nichelle.com. My passion is, as I mentioned, business, but I help people transition in their life from one stage to the next. And I do that by helping them find what their gift is. And so when we're talking about creative ways to find a job, I'm going to share with you the number one thing that you can pretty much tap this in right now. And I don't know if you've thought about this, but prospect your friends and your family. You know, oftentimes we don't say what we want to do. We don't talk to people enough and we don't know what people do. And so if you don't know what people do, how can they help you do what you want to do? And so when you're talking with your friends, it's nothing wrong with asking them, what are you doing now? Maybe you need to connect with some older relationships to find out what they're doing now. And social media is an excellent way to do that, especially if you're on Facebook. You can connect with people to find out what they're doing now, different careers, even if they own a business, to see if they're hiring. Perhaps maybe you can get your start right there for entrepreneurship if you're thinking about going into business. If it's a career, you can see if they're hiring. Perhaps maybe they'll bring you on board as well. But talking with people, finding out what people do is the greatest aspect of networking, especially people that are currently in your circle, your friends and your family. That is the first stop in this creative way to help you get the career of your choice for 2017. So send them a resume, ask them, you know, one thing that I've noticed too, I have a young lady, college student, they sent out an email chain. This young lady had her resume in there. She's getting ready to graduate May 2017. They sent out an email chain of this lady's resume to people in their email just to see if they're hiring. And so that's a creative aspect as well. Attach your resume, send it to a friend or family, and ask them to share it with their friends or their family so that they can know that you're getting ready to graduate or you're seeking a new job or you're interested in starting a business. Let people know what you do. So that's number one. Number two, attend a happy hour in a community where there are major employers. Attend a happy hour where there are major employers in that community. More so in the downtown area or the suburbs, wherever there are major employers. If you go to the local municipalities, you know, perhaps restaurants, a lot of them have happy hours 4 to 7. That is a perfect place for you to go to meet other people that may be in a profession that you choose. Now, one thing that I always share with my clients when we're talking about creative ways to find a job is that get some business cards with your name on them and your phone number. Your name and your phone number. If you get some business cards with your name and your phone number, that's a little resume, a mini resume, and you pass those out to people. Again, networking, talking, what did you do? Where are you located? And things of that sort. And so if you do that, it will clearly help give you preference to working with people in your network or outside of your network as well. And so if you get some little bitty cards, just regular business cards, your name, perhaps if you have a title or seeking, you can put a little bit of information on that business card, whatever career you're seeking, management, seeking a management position, and then your phone number, your email address. And one thing that I've been talking to my clients about as well, just because you don't have a business does not mean you should not have a website, because you can literally go to Wix.com and make you a little profile of a website, just like a resume, where people can go to and update, and look at your information and see what you do. Wix.com will allow you to make a resume online to put on your business cards along with your number and your email address and whatever career that you're seeking so that you can have that profile on that business card. So that's number two. Number three, this is the best way. I've gotten plenty of opportunity within entrepreneurship, and I've also gotten opportunity in corporate America by volunteering. People sleep on volunteering. Yes, you may not get paid right away. You may not get paid right away, but look, the purpose of you being there is to, first of all, get the experience, the exposure, and then get around something that you may like to do. A lot of people like the volunteer and the community service and things of that nature. So if you get in that environment, it will not only, as I mentioned, make people aware that first you're seeking employment or an opportunity. Perhaps maybe you want to start your own nonprofit organization. That's the perfect way to do it. Go volunteer. You get extra experience. Not only that, again, you make those connections. So volunteer at schools. If you're interested in getting into education, volunteer at schools, different organizations, groups, and companies. Companies take volunteers as well, you know, because they're trying to control their budget. And so that's a perfect place to go in and say, hey, I'll answer the phones for you, or I'll do administrative work, you know, for you as well, just to get your foot in the door. Typically, those people that do that, if they see how much of a hard work you are, you'll be the first one they hire before they go outside. And so that's a great thing to do. Volunteer. Number four, I've done this as well in my career seeking days and looking for opportunities. And even as a business owner, I've done this as well. Create a document of a problem that you see within that company. Now, mine, when I did this, it was for a home health agency. And I went into the home health, actually, I was servicing the home health agency, and I saw a problem that they were not funneling their referrals the correct way. So basically, what I did was send the manager of that home health company a document of a solution to that problem. I spotted different things, notated it on there, and then gave them a solution how I think it could change and improve their aspects of getting referrals. And from that, I end up getting that as a client to help them with their employment and getting people into that organization. And so the more creative that you step outside the box of the normality of what everybody else does, because see, just sending resumes don't work anymore. If you're just going to send resumes, you're going to be just like everybody else. So you got to do something different that other people aren't doing. You know, they've had people standing on a corner with a billboard saying, hire me. You know, even as a business owner, you got to go knock on doors. You can't just sit home behind the computer anymore and think the job or the business opportunity is going to come to you. You got to go get it if you want it. Okay, so that's number four. Create a document to management or someone who is a is the decision maker within an organization, and find a problem, because every company has a problem. Every company has a problem, and you be that solution to help them change their business, make more income, perhaps maybe get more buy-in from consumers or whatever. Find the solution, find the problem, and then you develop a solution, and that will show your creative side, and that will also make them in tune to who you are. And perhaps sometimes they even create positions for you. You know, they'll create a position for you if you find a problem and then you have a solution. Employers do it all the time. And so that is number four there. Number five, you want to find out who the hiring managers are. You know, LinkedIn is an excellent source as well. Facebook, find, because they have what they do up there on top of most of their profiles. Find what they do. And when you find what they do, connect with them or see who is in their network. And when you see who's in their network, send them a message that you are seeking employment, or you're seeking a business opportunity, or you got a business solution to help them. Send them a message. When you send them a message, reach out to them again. You know, I always say at least three times, you know, three times, reach out to them just so you can get your name out there. You can get out there what you're looking for as well. And then they can contact you back as well, too. So those are five creative ways. If you are seeking to change your finances in 2017, if you're seeking other opportunities, if you're seeking to even open up a business, all of these things that I mentioned to you, these five creative ways will help not only get your foot in the door, it will also get your name out there. And I even think when you're looking for opportunity, as I mentioned, you need to be as creative as possible. You want to put a game plan together. And how do you put a game plan together? Just like if you were starting a business, you will write a business plan. Putting a game plan together, your objectives for doing that. Because whether you know it or not, looking for a job is a tax write-off. You know, there are certain things that you need to be mindful of, and you need to check with your CPA or your accountant, whoever does your taxes, because I do taxes. And I know every time someone comes that you can write that off. That is a write-off allowable expense for seeking employment. Even starting a business, that's an allowable expense to write off on your taxes. And so The more creative, as I mentioned, that you are in any and everything that you do. One thing that we're doing too in my agency, we're doing video. When someone is interested in a position, we have them video us of them speaking. Public speaking is so important. As a members of the Toast, as a member of a Toastmaster organization, I've reached out to people to say, hey, you might want to join this organization or just visit and try to build your public speaking skills. Because no matter what we like, you know, I personally am not a video person, but you know, I know that this is part of where we're going career-wise. The resume is going to become obsolete really soon. And everything is going to be based on video, people acknowledging you through video and speaking to you. Hello, how are you? Welcome. Thank you for being here. So again, the more creative ways that you have in order to get your name out there, your business out there, have a plan. Don't go into anything without a plan in 2017. I cannot stress the importance of that. A strategy. Everything, business is nothing but strategy. Seeking a new career is nothing but strategy. Have a game plan. Where do you want to be? Do you want to have this job by the first quarter of the new year? Do you want to start this business by the first quarter of the new year? You got to have a game plan to get you from point A to point B. It has to be exclusive and inclusive of your goals and objectives. Because I tell you, as a hiring manager, one thing that I always look for is organization. When people come in, how they approach me, the steps, if they're timely in getting things back to me at a timely manner, you know, things that I request, you want to be on top of that, because those are the first things outside of first impressions or lasting impressions that people ask you for and expect you to be quick in providing that information. So that is my message for you today. I pray and hope that this resonates with you and that it gives you some ideas to step outside of your comfort zone, step outside that box. In fact, kick the box to the curb and do something different in 2017. My name is Nichelle with 2XL with Nichelle.com. If you like daily inspiration and motivation, join me on Instagram and on Twitter at Nichelle Womack. I'm also on Facebook for daily motivation and inspiration at The Life Transition Strategist. Forgot who I am and where I was. Thank you so much for that love. I greatly appreciate all those beautiful green hearts. To all my replay viewers, thank you for being here and coming in and tapping that screen, giving that love. And to all the Twitter viewers, thank you for being here. All the YouTube viewers and the People Connect podcast, I greatly appreciate each and every one of you. May everything you touch turn to gold. Be blessed and highly favored in everything that you do. Until next time, blessings and peace unto you. Thanks again. Bye-bye.